Hi, this is Dr. Sushma. A warm welcome to all of you to my channel, Dental Pictionary and Mnemonics. Today, I'll be discussing about the drugs which fall under the classification of cephalosporins. Cephalosporins are a group of semi-synthetic antibiotics which are chemically related to penicillins. Cephalosporins have been conventionally divided into five generations, and this division has a chronological sequence of development, but more importantly takes into consideration the overall antibacterial spectrum as well as the potency of drugs in various generations. All cephalosporins are bactericidal and have same mechanism of action as that of the penicillin, that is, they all inhibit cell wall synthesis of the bacteria. However, they bind to the different proteins than those which binds penicillins. This may explain the differences in the spectrum, potency and the lack of cross-resistance in cephalosporins as comparison to the penicillins. Classification of cephalosporins is an important topic, but it's very volatile. But I would provide you with a certain mnemonics and easier tricks to learn the drugs which fall under the category of various generations of cephalosporins. So let's get started. I'll tell you a short story. Once upon a time, there was Cephalosporin. Cephalosporin was specialized in making a dish, Cephalosporin C, which he used to make from a fungus, Cephalosporium. And now this fungus is also known as acrimonium. Cephalosporin is preparing Cephalosporin C preparations since five generations. And according to the generation, these preparations were classified into first, second, third, fourth, and fifth generation. Each successive generation was differ from the previous generation by the scope of antibacterial activity. Now we are going to deal with the drugs in each generation one by one. Drugs which fall under the first generation cephalosporins, their name starts from either SEF or SEPH-CEF. Or SEPRA, that means FA, FA and FRA. If these three are there, that means the drug belongs to the first generation cephalosporin. Also, we can see that the drugs which fall under the first generations, they have a vowel A. After SEF or SEPRA. And we know that A is the first letter in alphabets. So all drugs in first generation cephalosporins have alphabet A in their spellings. One mnemonic to remember the first generation drugs which are administered orally is Zil drank once in bottle, where Zil stands for cefadroxil and one stands for, that means it belongs to the first generation cephalosporins, and Zin stands for cephalexin. Cefradine is the drug which belongs to the first generation of cephalosporins, which can be administered orally as well as through the parenteral route. We will skip second generation cephalosporins as of now and will come back to it at the end. A simple trick to remember third generation cephalosporin is Me, 1 and 10, as they all end in one of those. Here the exception are two drugs, Ceftinir and Moxolactam. They are third generation cephalosporin medications, but despite they are not having 1-10 me ending. Here I would like to tell you one important point, that ceftazidime and cefoperazone are the third generation's antibiotic which are effective against pseudomonas. Now we will discuss about fourth generation cephalosporins. fourth generation cephalosporin, he prepared 2 pies. Along with the 2 pies, 4th generation cephalosporins associated with 2 peas. Out of 2 peas, 1 stands for the parenteral. That means these are the group of cephalosporin generation which is given through parenteral route only. And 2nd P stands for the anti-pseudomonal activity that 4th generation cephalosporin possess. 5th generation cephalosporin modified the original preparation and made it as a roll. So roll, R-O-L, is included in every name of the 5th generation cephalosporin. Now at last we will discuss about the 2nd generation cephalosporin. So this generation contains everything else that does not fit into other pattern which are discussed earlier. There are 2 exceptions, cefaclor and cefuroxime. Cefaclor though contains FA within the word, it's a 2nd generation medication and not a 1st generation medication. 2nd exception is cefuroxime, which ends with me, but it's a 2nd generation cephalosporin rather than a 3rd generation cephalosporin. Now we'll discuss about the antibacterial spectrum of various generation of cephalosporins. The 1st generation cephalosporin has a good activity against the gram-positive bacteria like streptococci and the staphylococci. 2nd generation cephalosporins have greater activity against the gram-negative bacteria and less activity against the gram-positive bacteria. 3rd generation cephalosporin has a very good activity against gram-negative bacteria and reasonable activity against gram-positive bacteria, which is less than that of the 1st generation and 2nd generation cephalosporins. 4th generation cephalosporins have a very broad spectrum including anti-pseudomonal action. 5th generation cephalosporins show the broad spectrum activity against gram-positive bacteria including MRSA and extensively resistant strains such as vancomycin, intermediate Staphylococcus aureus, heteroresistance vancomycin, intermediate Staphylococcus aureus and vancomycin resistant Staphylococcus aureus. After discussing the various drugs in the different generations of cephalosporins, it is also very equally important to know the bacteria against which the cephalosporins are not effective. And the mnemonic for this is MALE, where M stands for MRSA, A stands for atypical bacteria like mycoplasma and chlamydia, L stands for listeria and E stands for enterococci. Out of all the generations of cephalosporin, the 5th generation cephalosporins are effective against MRSA. The full form of MRSA is methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus. So this was all about the various drugs which falls under the different generations of cephalosporin in the easy way. Hope you like my video. Please share, like or comment and keep smiling. Always yearn to learn. Thank you. Have a nice day.